We get a lot of interesting mail about stories, but this particular letter is fascinating. It tells about a car that handles like it has four wheels, but doesn't, steers like it has power steering, but doesn't, gets 38 miles per gallon, and keeps you cool without air conditioning. Now that's a car that I've got to see. What are you going to call this thing?
I haven't decided that yet. I had thought about it, Tri-Vet, but there's a place in California that already took that. Might call it a Triad. We one time referred to it as a red, white, and bluebird.
No matter what you call this three-wheeled thingamabob, you have to admit that it's one of a kind. Jesse Crapo of Duluth, Georgia, is responsible for it. It's the result of 16 and a half years with General Motors in the paint shop, masking two-tone cars. As Jesse puts it, it's just natural for him to mess with stuff, and his personal tinkering and research led to this. Don't laugh. We should all be lucky enough to have a car that gets the gas mileage this buggy does.
Well, this started during the gasoline embargo, and the main object was to increase the gas mileage from a normal car. And by doing that, the route I went was in changing the shape of the car. And so they claim that the average car, 90% of the energy goes to wind resistance. The other 10 goes for running the car. So if you can reduce the wind resistance, you increase your gas mileage. Well, the front end, the shape is a safety design, really. In other words, if you can get close to missing something, you slide off of it, which is not a sudden stop. And another thing is the front wheel was the only way you could get that pointed front end was with the one front wheel.
It breezed through the Georgia Auto Safety Inspection. Legally, it's a 1963 Volkswagen, but about all you could find of that car is the engine. The rest is pure Jesse Crapo. The car is a puzzle, with wind resistance as the answer. His body design, one less wheel, flow through ventilation, and ingenuity produced a comfortable 38 miles per gallon at highway speeds.
Right.
You expect the world is going to beat a path to your door now?
No, I think you have to. It works the other way around. You build a mousetrap, but you still got to beat a path to the demand.
The big car manufacturers have their special torture tracks for checking their cars to make sure they work right. Jesse doesn't, but his backyard is quite a test. Outside of Duluth, Georgia, I'm Andy Johnston.